Microsoft is reportedly going to force encrypt all of your files with BitLocker when you install Windows 11 24H2 or later. Now, this has a lot of people saying that you will lose all of your files and that you shouldn't install the Windows 11 24H2 update because of that. But it's actually not as bad as you think. So let me explain. Encrypting your files is not a bad thing at all. In fact, it's actually one of the best ways to keep the data on your computer secure in the event that your computer gets stolen, for example. But this is where the issues with data encryption start, especially if you're not aware that your data is being encrypted. Let's say that BitLocker encryption is enabled on your computer. Your computer crashes for some reason. It could be due to a bad Windows update, for example. You can't get back into Windows, and you're someone who doesn't ever make backups of their data, like a lot of people still don't do these days. Now you want to recover your files, and you can't. Even when you take it to a computer repair shop, there's nothing they can do unless you provide them with the BitLocker recovery key. In fact, they can't even begin to troubleshoot the issue with your computer or fix it because they need to enter the BitLocker recovery key before they can do anything. That basically only leaves you with one option. You'll have to start from scratch on a new Windows install without your data. So in this video, I want to go over a few very important things you absolutely must know regarding the automatic encryption of your data, and at the end of the video, I'll show you how you can disable the forced BitLocker drive encryption too with a simple registry entry. Now for starters, the automatic drive encryption is reportedly only going to be enabled on a clean install of Windows 11 24H2 and won't affect upgrades to 24H2. So if you're upgrading from Windows 10 or Windows 11 22H2 for example, and BitLocker is turned off on your current Windows installation, it won't be automatically enabled once you upgrade to Windows 11 24H2. Now you can check if BitLocker is currently enabled on your computer by right-clicking on the Start button and then selecting System. In the related settings, just click on the BitLocker settings here, and then you'll be able to see if it's enabled or not. If you don't even have the BitLocker settings option, then you're probably on a home version of Windows, and you don't need to worry about it on your current installation. If it is enabled, you have the option to disable it here as well. Now let's say that you want to use BitLocker to keep your data secure. What should you do in that case? Well, in that case, you must make a backup of your BitLocker recovery key, and you can do that here. You can either save it in a file, but you can't save that file on the computer, obviously, because the data is encrypted. So you'll have to save it on a USB flash drive, or you can upload it to a cloud service like Google Drive or OneDrive, for example. So that way you'll still have access to it in the event that your computer crashes. The other option is to save it to a Microsoft account, and you'll only see this option if you're currently signed into a Microsoft account on the computer that you're using. So if you've saved it to your Microsoft account, how can you get it back in the event that your PC crashes? To do that, you can do a Google search for Microsoft account login and then go to the Microsoft account login page. Then you need to sign into the same Microsoft account that you used to sign in on the BitLocker enabled computer, the one where the BitLocker recovery key is backed up on. Once you're signed in, you'll see a Devices tab like you can see here, and then you can click on this View All Devices button to show all the devices you've logged into using your Microsoft account. Now, if you have more than one device here, you just need to find the correct device, and then you need to click on this Show Details button here. On this next page, you should have this BitLocker Data Protection tab here with this option to manage your recovery keys. If you click on that, it'll load a new page and show you the recovery key. From here, you can print out the recovery key so you have a hard copy of it, or you can just print it to a PDF file, for example. Then once you have the recovery key, you can then enter it on the BitLocker recovery screen and you'll be able to access the drive and the data and potentially repair your computer again in the event that it's crashed. So that's basically how you can manage BitLocker and the recovery keys, but do you really need to worry about BitLocker on Windows 11 24H2? Well, I've done a few tests and this is what I've found using the insider preview version of Windows 11 24H2. So things might change in the future, but this is how it is for now. During my tests, I found that BitLocker will only be enabled on a clean install of Windows 11 24H2 on supported hardware if you sign in with a Microsoft account during the onboarding experience. I'm also pretty sure that the BitLocker recovery key will automatically be saved to the linked Microsoft account in this case. So you will be able to get the BitLocker recovery key from your Microsoft account using the method that I showed you earlier in the event that your computer crashes. Now, if you do a clean install of Windows 11 24H2 on supported hardware and you bypass the Microsoft account creation and sign in with a local account, BitLocker will not be enabled by default. Now, one thing to note is that here you'll see that it says BitLocker encrypting and you might think that it's enabled, right? But right next to it here, you have the option to turn on BitLocker, which makes you think that it's disabled. Also, you'll see if I go to this PC and look at the drive here, I also have the option to turn on BitLocker, which again makes me think that it's disabled. But you'll see if I go to Disk Management and have a look at the drive here, it actually shows that the drive is BitLocker encrypted. So what's going on? Well, the answer is that the data on the drive is not encrypted. And you'll see I can prove that to you if I boot into the recovery options here. So if I try and access the command prompt here, I can still view the files on the C drive, meaning it's not encrypted by BitLocker. The reason that it says BitLocker encrypting here is that it's in a ready state, but the files are not encrypted yet. So if I were to enable it, it would just take less time to actually encrypt all the contents on the drive compared to starting the drive encryption from scratch. But the short answer is BitLocker is still disabled and your data is not encrypted. And if you do a clean install of Windows 11 24H2 on unsupported hardware with no secure boot or TPM, BitLocker will not be enabled by default regardless if you choose to use a Microsoft account to sign in during the onboarding experience. So basically, BitLocker will only be enabled by default on Windows 11 supported PCs that use a Microsoft account to sign in during the onboarding experience. That means if you're running Windows 11 on an unsupported PC or you're planning to upgrade to Windows 11 24H2 on an unsupported PC, you don't have to worry about the forced BitLocker encryption at all. So who actually needs to worry about the forced BitLocker encryption? Well, in my opinion, it'll be someone who's about to set up a new laptop with a Microsoft account, whether that be a home user or a computer technician. One thing you can do is you can go through the normal setup process like you always do and sign in with a Microsoft account. Then once you've loaded into the user profile, you can just go to the BitLocker settings like I explained earlier and then just disable the BitLocker drive encryption inside of Windows here. But if you want to disable the forced BitLocker encryption altogether, here's how you can do that. So once you get to this first screen of the Windows onboarding experience where you can choose your region and language settings, you can press Shift and F10 together on your keyboard and it's going to open up a command prompt window. Now on certain laptops, you might have to press Shift, the function key and F10 together for the command prompt to open. But in the command prompt window, you can type taskmgr.exe and then press Enter and that's going to open the task manager. Now you can just click on Run New Task and then type regedit, select this checkbox here to open it with admin privileges and then just click on OK. That's going to open the registry editor and then you'll need to navigate to the following key. So it's going to be HKey local machine, then system, current control set, control, and then you'll have this BitLocker key here. Now you need to right click in this empty white space here and then create a new DWORD 32-bit value and then you need to call it prevent device encryption, exactly like you see it here. Once it's created, just double click on it and change the value from 0 to 1 and then click on OK. Now once you're done with that, you can close all of these windows here and then you can go through the onboarding experience like always. Now I'm going to sign in with a Microsoft account here since we know BitLocker won't be enabled without it. And now I'm going to show you that if we go to the settings and we have a look at the BitLocker settings here, it is disabled. And as you can see from my account up here, I am signed into the Microsoft account. So that registry key that we created prevented the forced BitLocker encryption, and that's a cool little trick that you can use to prevent the drive from being automatically encrypted. But like I said at the start of the video, BitLocker drive encryption is not a bad thing and it can help keep your data secure. The issue is when Microsoft forces it on you without you even knowing about it. And sadly, a lot of people won't know about it, and it's the same type of people who don't even know they use a Microsoft account to sign in on their computers, and they won't be able to provide you with the BitLocker recovery key because they just don't know about it. Hopefully, this video makes those types of people more aware of BitLocker and how to manage their recovery keys. But with that being said, I hope you found some value in this video. Please remember to give it a like, and I'll talk to you guys soon.